Hope.
Connection.
Integration.
Support.
Resources.
Care.
Compassion.
Community.
Concern.
Learning.
Optimism.
Engelhard.
The Engelhard Project aims to bridge the divide often seen in students' lives between their academics and their experiences outside the curriculum. The project goal is to promote growth and development and to make explicit the connections between their academics and their personal health and decision making.
I believe it fits with Georgetown's mission because part of who we are as a Jesuit institution is place that focuses on the whole student and on caring for the student.
The insight of the Engelhard Project is very similar to what the insight of Kerr Personalis is. It's not just about care for all these different aspects kept separate, but it's also care for the whole person.
The model that we use for the Engelhard Project is something called curriculum infusion, where faculty and health professionals work to integrate issues of mental wellness with academic content into courses. Through curriculum infusion, students then get to link these wellness issues to the academic content by connecting them to their own real life experiences. At the heart of curriculum infusion is the module, and every module has at least three elements. At least one reading that connects the topic to the course content, a presentation or discussion led by a campus health professional, and a student-written reflection on the way the module helps them connect to the course content.
Curriculum infusion as a model is really very practical and portable, and these health and wellness topics can really be integrated into pretty much any course content. For instance, in an English class, they've used their readings and the text of the readings and looking at character development and exploring issues that might be pertinent to those characters in terms of the class or what issues are going on for the person. And in a math or chemistry class, we've looked at alcohol and drug interactions in the body. So the options really are pretty much endless.
Essentially, this project asks faculty and health professionals to think creatively and ask, where is that sweet spot where the intellectual material of a course could be opened up into a more personal vein for students?
I incorporated the Engelhard curriculum infusion into my introduction to community psychology class. We were already learning about how people respond to and are influenced by their community contexts. We were studying issues of prevention and empowerment and wellness and stress and coping. So the Engelhard Project fit very well into those concepts we were learning. And what it enabled us to do is to allow students to bring those concepts home to their own lives and understand themselves in the Georgetown community, just as we were understanding people in neighborhoods and larger communities around the U.S. and around the world.
The material became more personal and more real, and so I wanted to learn more. I became more engaged as a student, and other students did as well. We wanted to come to class. We wanted to do well.
This class and Professor Spooler's attitude it reminds me of why I'm here. Basically that I'm here to grow, to learn, and ultimately to want to learn more, because sometimes in a collegiate academic environment, I think we try so hard to get that A or A minus or B plus that we get very competitive and we forget the big picture.
In terms of the students, feedback that I got from several of them was that they also appreciated putting a face to a name and being able in a neutral environment to ask questions that they had about mental health or wellness issues, as well as how services worked at Georgetown.
I think before taking this class, a lot of us are not even sure that there was a CAP service on campus, but Dr. Maiman came over and talked to us about exactly what CAPS does and what's involved in counseling, talked about the cost, but mainly he addressed about how it's almost a taboo to go to CAPS, that people talk about you and wondering if you're having any serious problems, but he definitely made the service much more real and personal.
I took mathematical modeling with Professor Sandifer, and instead of just being a normal math class, we used Excel a lot and formulas. He brought reality to those formulas, and different professionals from campus came in and spoke to us about alcohol education and alcohol awareness, as well as awareness about eating disorders. So we were able to understand them mathematically and why they have the effect and the consequences that they have, and then also on a personal level and how they affect students and when people need help and how to help them.
Students have been inundated with information about eating disorders, about nutrition, and even more so about alcohol and the dangers of alcohol, and they've been getting it all from one perspective. And they actually know very little about the interactions in the body, and so by bringing it in as a math model and talking about the way alcohol is eliminated, how it's built up in the body, the students were finding that this material was a totally different way of seeing problems of alcoholism and alcohol than they'd been presented before.
I think the style of learning in the Engelhard program, of bringing in the health information, really makes it very real for students, and it makes it something that they can relate to. And they take away more than just the mathematical formulas that they might forget in a couple of years, but it's really a lifelong lesson that they can remember for years to come.
I had one student talking that put in there and said, well, you know, I don't sit there and particularly measure the amount of alcohol I drink, but I do notice that I keep count of how many drinks I've had. And so it let me know that they're really thinking about it, and I think changing and making changes in their behavior.
One of the exciting things about this project is that we've been able to reach a substantial number of students with a significant but limited number of faculty. Over the past 4 years, more than 3,000 students have taken one of about 100 different Engelhard courses, representing 20 different departments. We think we need about 45 to 50 courses per year to reach an entire entering class of 1,600 students.
Beyond any numbers, though, we are seeing a qualitative impact on our classrooms. Students are learning better, they're more engaged, and the classroom environment has become more interactive. And we're seeing that spill out into their personal lives.
With the advent of the Engelhard and it spreading out more and more into the classroom, we've seen risk reduction occur on this campus. We're seeing problem-based behavior going down. We see students feeling more adjusted. We see students having less major problems. We see students going out and putting themselves and others at risk in a much more reduced way.
The Engelhard Project is one of the most powerful ways I've seen of bringing different people together in the interest of more deeply engaging our students in the learning process and improving the health of our students at the same time.
We have a great program. It's clearly having a positive impact on the lives of many, many students. It's clearly having a positive impact, I think, on the faculty who are involved. And it's been a great program for those of us in student affairs who have been working with the faculty. But I think if we expand it, I think it will really have a positive impact on the culture of Georgetown.
It's really bringing people together for the first time around a holistic education of the student. So faculty and health professional staff are interacting in new and different ways, and I think faculty are being perceived by the student as being really much more interested and involved in their lives personally.
The courses that I'm going to most remember are my Engelhard courses, and the faculty I'm going to stay in touch with are those professors who taught those classes for me. And that the reason those courses were different was because I didn't feel that I was necessarily just getting a degree, but I was getting a Georgetown education.